Good morning. Well, last week we looked at the first three verses of Psalm 27, and today I want to look at verses 4 through 6. Psalm 27, verses 4 to 6, and I'm reading from the New International Version. One thing I ask of the Lord, this is what I seek, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to gaze upon the beauty of the Lord and to seek Him in His temple. For in the day of trouble, He will keep me safe in His dwelling. He will hide me in the shelter of His tabernacle and set me high upon a rock. Then my head will be exalted above the enemies who surround me. At His tabernacle will I sacrifice with shouts of joy. I will sing and make music to the Lord. Thanks be to God for His holy word. Well, verse 4 says, one thing I ask of the Lord, this is what I seek, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to gaze upon the beauty of the Lord and to seek Him in His temple. David's great desire is to dwell in the house of the Lord. Sounds a lot like the end of Psalm 23. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. But Psalm 23 seems to refer to heaven and eternity, whereas Psalm 27 is a reference to the earthly dwelling of the Lord, namely the tent or the tabernacle. And David uses multiple words to describe it. He calls it the house of the Lord, the temple, the shelter, and the tent. So why is David longing for God's house? It's certainly not for the beauty of the temple. For remember, at this point, it is more of a tent than a temple. Solomon's great temple is years in the future. So David is referencing the tent that he set up for the Ark of the Covenant. The answer is that it's not so much the earthly temple that David desired, but it was the beauty of the Lord to be found in that temple that David wanted. It is the Lord Himself that David is seeking. And yet we must acknowledge that he seeks God's beauty in the temple or the tent of the Lord, because that's the place where they regularly experience God and worship God. Therefore, in Psalm 42, the psalmist speaks of thirsting after God as he leads the procession to the house of God. Or the psalmist declared in Psalm 84:10, a day in your courts is better than a thousand elsewhere. You see, David and the devout Israelites longed to be in the house of the Lord, to experience the beauty of the Lord. You know, what's interesting to me is how often during this pandemic I've seen posts reminding us that the church is not a building, it's the people. And I myself have said things like this: though we're apart, we're still the church, we're still one body. And while all that is true, and while I've worshiped God sitting in my kayak on Philpot or after climbing to the top of Buffalo Mountain, there's still something incredibly special to be experienced as the church comes together in one place. Otherwise, says pastor and commentator James Montgomery Boyce, why have churches? Boyce continues, if it's only instruction we need, well, we can get that by audio tape or book. And today we might add by podcasts or live streaming. He continues, if it's only fellowship, we can find that in a small home gathering. But he says, there's something to be said for the sheer physical singing of the hymns, the sitting in the pews, the actual looking to the pulpit as the Bible is expounded, the tasting of the sacrament, and the very atmosphere of the place set apart for worship of God that is spiritually beneficial. You know, I don't know about you, but that's been my experience. There's a profound sense of God's presence that I find in God's house that I find nowhere else. Again, I agree with Pastor Boyce when he says, I do not mean to deny that God can and should be worshiped elsewhere, but I am suggesting that the physical worship of God in the company of other believers can be almost sacramental. I agree. And it is this seeking God in the company of other believers that I have missed the most during the past months. So I long for the day, folks, when more of the body of Christ called Stuart Presbyterian Church can gather to gaze upon the beauty of the Lord and to seek Him here in this house of the Lord. And church, I hope you long for that as well. Well, let's pray together. Oh Lord, we see Your beauty everywhere. As another Psalm of David declares, there's nowhere that we are apart from Your presence. And yet there's something very special when Your people gather as the body of Christ. Your Spirit seems to be present here in such a special way as we sing together and pray together and read Your Word together. So Lord, please open the way that more of us might physically gather together as the body of Christ. Oh Lord, drive away this virus so that we can get out more, and most importantly, so that the church can gather to gaze upon Your beauty. Certainly help us see Your beauty even in something like this devotional recording. But draw Your church together again. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, God bless you, church. Keep praying for the day when we can all be back together to gaze upon the beauty of the Lord. Go in peace. Have a great day. Goodbye.